So you're saying persecuted minorities will get certain benefits. Let me ask you.
See, if the law is passed by the parliament.
Sure. Simple question then. Rohingya Muslims, they are being persecuted in Myanmar. You are deporting them because they are Muslims. Why don't you apply? I am saying apply the same standard.
No.
You will apply the same standard based on the religion of the community. Rohingya Muslim, just a few, 7 of them have been deported only yesterday. You will approve of that? Is that the right thing that has been done?
Nay. When Rajdeep is in power, this act that is being made,
yes,
it can be extended to whole world. Right now, this act applies only to Afghanistan, Pakistan, and Bangladesh. It doesn't apply to Myanmar. Country is guided by laws, my friend, not by emotions in the studios. The law that we have today is applicable to erstwhile India, British India.
Do you think
Rohingya? We are only giving extensively to Afghanistan, Pakistan, and Bangladesh, where if minorities out of persecution come to India,
Sir, when the Dalai Lama came, we welcomed him. He was a persecuted minority at the time in Tibet. Today, when it comes to Rohingyas, you are suddenly reminding me of the law of the land. You know, I am amused at one level how the law is selectively used in this country. It suits your political agenda, your critics say, to target the Rohingya Muslims. Now there is the new subtext, they are all terrorists. Suddenly I am told that Rohingya Muslims who have been living for several years, now they are terrorists. I just want to understand, what is the larger goal of the BJP government? Is it to identify those who are Muslims, who are illegal immigrants, and ask them to leave the country, NRC being one step in that process? Or is it that every illegal immigrant will be told, sorry, you're a stateless citizen, India is no longer a dharamshala for you?
No, I am surprised that you are calling Dalai Lama an illegal immigrant. The conventional sense about Dalai Lama is not that. Dalai Lama, when he came as a persecuted leader from Tibet, he was welcomed not by any BJP government, but the then government led by Prime Minister Nehru. We accorded them the status of guests in our country, and they are not given any citizenship. Neither do they want it. They want to retain their whatever identity they have. Now, see, as far as Rohingya issue is concerned, I really do not want to make it into a big political controversy or anything, but let me tell you, even the problem is faced more acutely by our neighbor, Bangladesh. Bangladesh is actively engaging with Myanmar to find a way to send, repatriate them back to their area, the Rakhine province in Myanmar. This is a process that every country undertakes. That's why I'm saying what we are doing with illegal infiltrators is not something that only we are doing. Sure. World over. Why is Trump building a fence across America-Mexico border?
You want
is
us?
Is it that...
You see Trump as a role model?
No. But is the question about infiltrators, why is... It's about American government taking a decision. And I mean... For your own thing, that leader of American government, if you don't want to recognize it, it's your problem.
Sure.
My point is the American government is building a kind of a fence across the border. Why? Because it's not any self-interest of anybody. They want to secure their border. They want to secure it from infiltration.
Sure.
It happens world over. Unfortunately, in our country, we make a controversy out of something that is a very normal constitutional process everywhere.
You know, you're calling it normal constitutional process, but you have used the word, you are meaning, again, your party, but you also, that you will, as I asked you originally, disenfranchise and eventually deport them. Now, where will they go is my question. Because Bangladesh, which is a neighboring country with whom we have friendly relations, has made it very clear, we are not taking them back. So what will you do with these people? These are individuals. Today, it's very nice for me to call them termites, to call them illegal immigrants. They are human beings. This is a great country, great civilization, which has accepted waves of people. Today, let us assume that they are illegal. Please tell me, where will we throw them? Into the Padma, into the Hooghly, into the Bay of Bengal?
Rajdeep,
because Bangladesh has said we will not accept them.
Rajdeep, your bleeding heart had it bled for those Indians who were thrown out of Saudi Arabia last year, I would have been really happy. But your heart bleeds selectively, that everybody knows in the country. But having said it, your selective bleeding, let it happen. But what I'm saying is...
My heart bleeds for every citizen.
Let me answer your question.
Yes.
I am saying we are following a very constitutional process.
Yes.
When we reach there, I wish India Today long life. You will be there when that position comes. You will have another conclave in Guwahati. I want you to hold that conclave. So we will discuss that when we reach there. I am saying there are several bridges to cross. We are right at the beginning. You are asking about the end point. We will discuss when we come there.
No, because I
we'll
think
we will certainly discuss.
No, I think you
that maybe you will be in power. Then you can decide how to deport them. You will have a very wise way of deporting, infiltrators. I mean, maybe you will have an idea. We will ask them at that time.
Sir.
But let the process go on now. Sure.